Welcome to my private tutor, sir. My first question is, five unique features which actually segregates your institute from the counterparts.
Yes, see, according to me, like we basically, I lead a tutorial named Excellence Tutorial. And here we don't teach in bulk like other professional tutorials do. And usually we take up batches for maximum strength of 10 or like that, so that we can we could give attention to individual students. Then secondly, like we organize crash courses, like depending on the requirement of students. For example, like say if any students of class 10 or 12th standard enroll with us prior to the board exam, like he or she may be from ICSE or IC or anything like that. So in that short period, we cover up the syllabus and basically we focus on those areas where they would get like maximum questions and can end up with good marks, all right? And third, like, see, we have many students who usually enroll from outstations, like most of our students are outstation candidates also. Like to name some of them are from, I have many students from Bakura, Kharagpur, Durgapur also. So they follow us for our notes and basically we give out some handouts on physics, chemistry and biology. So they and apart from this, like we provide online services. And to give a brief explanation on this is that, like basically suppose students just come to know or just as they surf on net, they look into our website and then we have made a column over there for online students. So they basically send their queries. We have a form there. They send their queries and they can also enroll with us from there. So what we do is that we understand what the subjects they require, what areas they require the guidance. So accordingly, we provide them notes. And what happens is that we find that in Kolkata, in outside Kolkata, there is a big problem for students to get good tutors. And so, and moreover, it's if they we want to come over here, it's a very time consuming, and so we try to save their time and we give them the notes and then like if they have any queries regarding that, we provide them online classes also. And fourthly, like we provide free counseling, counseling for students and their parents along with the faculty. Like since I can understand this because since I being also one of them, the faculties, so like what happens is that it helps from faculty's point of view. Like it helps us to judge the merits and the demerits of the student, and also the student also like gets acquainted with us. And moreover, like it's like they want us, like if we have an interacting session like that, that helps us to analyze like what is the in what level the student exactly is, so that when after they get enrolled in our tutorial, we just provide like we start in that level teaching, so that that he can easily grasp those things. Okay. And finally, like we maintain a database like of students, and mostly what we do is that we provide an interactive session between our ex students and our present students, and this is a very this becomes very interactive because like our ex students, they share their experiences with us, and secondly also it creates an interest for the students. Okay, sometimes I find that most of the students in my part, I teach biology, and in medical exams there is a huge part called botany. So most of the students don't find any interest in that area. But last few years we have started this, like the students, we call our previous ex-students. So they share how we taught them or how which are the key areas to learn botany. So and make botany more interesting. So and I find that in the present student that created an interest. So basically these things I think that we usually feature in our tutorial. So to create the interest of the students. That's it.
Okay, so you spoke about botany. So I want to ask you in respect to that only. Like in the age of engineering and medical, do you think botany as a subject is actually losing its relevance?
No. This is a very very wrong concept of people. Like botany, since like nowadays people are running after engineering, computer science and all those. But as such, from my point of view, I find that there is still very, very, botany is still very knowledgeable. Like to give you some examples, like it would give you a clear concept of botany. Like see, basically people think that botany is nothing but like learning about plants. Yes, partly it is true. But if you know that botany has very very medical uses, like most of the plants have medical uses, and you know, like day to day life we are taking lots of medicine for anything, for our knowingly or unknowingly. But if you look into the composition, most of them are being extracted from plants, and that's a very tricky area of botany.
Okay. So my next question is, like, what are the different courses that your institute offers?
Okay, so see, in our institute, we conduct normal tuition for classes for 8 to 12 standard in the areas of biology, physics, chemistry, and mathematics. Apart from this, our tutorial, our objective is to create students or for preparing for medical exam. That's the key objective. We focus on that area, and we have many students enrolled for last 6 to 7 years. We are having this. We conduct fresh courses for board exams. Like usually, I find that many students after taking their classes from various tutors, might be some doesn't cope up with the with them, or they doesn't match with the expectations what they expect from the tutors. So mostly we get a bulk of students enrolled during this month for 12th standard and 10th standard during December or January. So they usually come for crash courses, and we organize crash courses for CBSE, ICSE, IIT, and West Bengal Board too, where we teach the key areas from where they expect maximum questions. And there are always these boards have always some tricky areas where you can score maximum, and where you can and moreover, like what we do is that we highlight on, you know, we guide the students that how much time they should spend on each topic, so that once that area is known to them, then like they can easily spend more time on that area. And lastly, we also conduct classes for coaching for engineering graduates and for postgraduates. Like it is a the courses are for biotechnology, genetics, molecular biology, biochemistry, and also microbiology. And another key area which we find that in you won't find any tutorial teaching that is bioinformatics. In Kolkata, since bioinformatics is my domain, I work on this field. So what we do is that in our tutorial we have many research scholars, and I also being one of them, we teach bioinformatics here for M.Tech, B.Tech, and this B.Sc. and M.Sc. students of biotechnology. So these are the courses like we usually conduct on regular basis.
Okay. So I would like to ask you, like today, as you can see, there is a trend to join any institute before appearing for any entrance exam. So if you could give us your view on this statement.
Yes, that's a very key question. Like I find that, students doesn't know how to prepare for a competitive exam. And mostly like in schools also, teachers, I find that teachers are teaching, they are following only the textbook and they have a very stipulated time period. You already know, like most schools have a class strength of 40 to 50 students. So it's not possible for a teacher also to guide individually to every student, all right? And most of the time we find that those who are very meritorious students, they usually end up with a good marks. Those who are mediocre students, they end up with an average mark. So what happens is that if you get enrolled to a good institute, the good institute builds up the knowledge and guides the candidate where exactly he or she has to focus and spend more time on it. And moreover, like these institutes like channelize their students by guiding them with the thorough knowledge about the question pattern. Like most of them, the students, they doesn't know what the question pattern is, how to arrange that. That yes, time management is another important thing. That like how you can answer maximum question within minimal time. So that's like that's where the tutorials or the institutes give you the knowledge, like your what is the question pattern and what is the, like most of the competitive exams, they are having MCQ based questions, right? And moreover, students think that if they are strong in the subject, they think that then MCQs are the questions are very easy. But that is a very, very wrong idea. The wrong idea because, in MCQ-based questions, there is a trick is that there are always two options which are very closely related to each other. And most of the time, students give up due to lack of time, students give up a wild guess. And that's the problem because most of the MCQ exams, they have negative marking. And there, if they have a wrong answer, then they end up with a very bad score. So what we do or what the institutes do is that they guide the students by identifying their weak and the strong areas, okay? And then secondly, like it helps the students to take decision during the exam hall, which questions need to be given higher priority and where to draw special attention. So, and moreover, like my institute and like other professional institutes, they also provide like regular tests and they build up the knowledge and also they analyze, they give the idea like where exactly your weak points are, where you must work out, and also this helps to bring the confidence. And because I am sure that because schools cannot provide these areas because they have limited time and they have to end up with a vast syllabus, and also moreover the classes which are being allotted in the schools are also very limited. So so I think that students that these institutes always help students to for preparing for entrance exams. That's my view.
Okay, so you must be adopting some unique methods to impart education to the students who actually register with your institute. So if you could tell us something about those methods.
Yes. Firstly, what we do is that like as a student enroll with us, okay. So suppose I'm giving you an example, like if a candidate enrolls with us for a medical entrance exam, okay. So what we do is that we take classes based on NCERT and we have prescribed books also, so and also notes also. We provide that. secondly is that like once in a month, as you know that most of the subjects are based on modules, and in biology, in chemistry, in physics, math, in, mostly in biology, physics, chemistry, these are module based syllabus. Okay, so we usually conduct finish each and every module, and after that like we conduct a discussion session. Once the discussion session is an open session or an open forum for students, like they can ask as questions to the faculties, and we are here to answer them. And after that has been cleared, the next particular day we conduct an exam. This is based on MCQ based questions as well as descriptive questions. Okay, and one thing I forgot to tell you that we have developed some infrastructure, that is like we have introduced the projectors so that we also provide that we have presentations, so we show that presentations also, and mostly these are these are all based on diagrams, and we show the diagrams mostly, that is like they would be getting in during the exam, and which can make their concept clear. And secondly, we also provide some animations, like animations in the sense like we show students like there are some topics like in biology, mostly this is done in biology and physics. Basically in biology we have some topics called protein synthesis, transcription, translation. So basically what we do is that this is a very key area where we find that students get very less marks due to lack of knowledge. And we show them there are some videos, like some YouTube videos, and these videos help them that they can rather than mugging out, we try to tell how you can gain the concept. So once that is clear, the picture is clear, so during the exam they can visualize that and write the correct answer. So these are the areas what we usually follow, and like this we try to create the interests of the students. Okay,
so visualization and practical application is very important.
Correct.
So moving on to my last question, how has my private tutor helped with your tutoring business so far?
That's a very very true, and to be honest enough, from my side, it's I suggest that since I am a registered member of this private tutor, and I think that this my private tutor is a very interactive portal between students and faculties. So like I also didn't have before I enrollment, I heard my private tutor's name, but once I got enrolled with you, then I find that this my private tutor.com tries to find out or understand the requirement of students as well as the teachers, and to me it is like they provide the actual knowledge that they like which student require what type of faculties, and mostly from as a faculty's point of view, like my private tutor is has given me huge pool of students for medical as well as for who want to take biology on that. So I got many students from your side, and mostly like, and they got enrolled with me, and this has already helped me, because like myprivatetutor.com has analyzed my skills, and accordingly they have supplied me a good pool of students for medical and for courses also. So like, and I'm also very much satisfied with the service they provide, and mostly it has been very 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 important, because and from my side I would also suggest that students should always look into this myprivatetutor.com this site, so that they can get the best faculties which are available here, because I think that you maintain a very good database of both students and faculty. So I got a very good students, and also these students are very meritorious. So I would have, it has, my private tutor has always helped me to get a good pool of students, because if I would have tried myself, so I won't have got so many students as your site has provided me. So it's, once again, I would thank you for your service. Okay, so, and it's a very good unique thing, and I think that you in near future also this site would grow up. And as you know that this internet is becoming, is coming, India is growing, and internet, everyone is accessing internet. So, and mostly there are curious students, and this would be increasing day by day. They would be also seeing your site, and as a faculty like me, I would also suggest more faculties to enroll here, so that they can get, you know, like good, after all, our aim is to get good students, and you are the site which provide good students as well as good faculty. So that thing, it's helping me a lot, and still till now I find very positive in my career, or also in my professional. So I would recommend other professionals also to get enlisted into this. Okay.
So it is lovely to hear such feedbacks from our clients, and I would really thank you for your time and for this interview. Thank you so much.
It's my pleasure.